Hello, I wish to register a complaint. Hello, miss.
What do you mean, miss?
I'm sorry, I have a cold. I wish to make a complaint.
Sorry, we're closed for lunch.
Never mind that, my lad. I wish to complain about this parrot, what I purchased not half an hour ago from this very boutique.
Oh, yes, the Norwegian blue. What's wrong with it?
I'll tell you what's wrong with it, my lad. It's dead. That's what's wrong with it.
No, he's resting.
Look, matey, I know a dead parrot when I see one. And I'm looking at one right now.
No, he's not dead, he's resting. Remarkable bird, the Norwegian blue, isn't it? Beautiful plumage.
The plumage don't enter into it. He's stone dead.
No, he's resting.
All right, then. If he's resting, I'll wake him up. Hello, Mr. Polly Parrot. I got a lovely fresh cuttlefish for you if you wake up.
There he moved.
No, he didn't. That was you pushing the cage.
I never.
Yes, you did. Hello, Polly Parrot. Wakey, wakey. This is your 9 o'clock alarm call. Now, that's what I call a dead parrot.
He's stunned.
He's stunned?
Yeah, you stunned him, just he was waking up. Norwegian blues stun easily.
Now, look, matey, I've had just about enough of this. That parrot is definitely deceased. When I purchased him not half an hour ago, you assured me that its total lack of movement was due to it being tired and shagged out following a prolonged squawk.
He's probably pining for the fjords.
Pining for the fjords? What kind of talk? Look, why did he fall flat on his back the moment I got him home?
The Norwegian blue prefers kipping on his back. Remarkable bird, isn't it, Squire? Beautiful plumage.
Look, I took the liberty of examining that parrot when I got it home, and I discovered that the only reason it had been sitting on its perch in the first place was that it had been nailed there.
of course it was nailed there. If I hadn't nailed that bird down, it would have muscled up those bars, ripped them apart with its beak, and vroom, 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 vroom,
vroom, vroom. Matey, this parrot wouldn't vroom if you put 4 million volts through it. It's bleeding demised.
No. He's pining.
He's not pining. He's passed on. This parrot is no more. He has ceased to be. It's a stiff, bereft of life. It rests in peace. If you hadn't nailed it to the perch, it would be pushing up the daisies. It's kicked the bucket, run down the curtain, and joined the bleeding choir invisible. It's extinct in its entirety. To put it another way, its metabolic processes are a matter of interest only to historians. This is an ex-parrot.
Well, I better replace it then.
Blimey, you want to get anything done in this country, by which I mean the United Kingdom and its overseas dependencies, you have to complain till you're blue in the face.
Sorry, Squire, I've had a look round the back and we're right out of parrots.
I see. I get the picture.
I've got a slug.
A slug?
Yeah, slug.
I see. And pray, does this slug of yours talk?
Not really.
Well, it's scarcely a replacement, is it?
Look.
What?
Do you want to come back to my place?
I thought you'd never ask.
All right.